Good morning, everyone. It's Liz. Happy Wednesday, happy fall. Today I wanted to hop on and talk about how your own healing is the greatest contribution you can make to the world and the greater good. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Dr. Liz Gutierrez. I'm a psychiatrist and soul guide that helps people reconnect to their true divine nature. And in my work with clients, I have the honor and privilege of really accompanying people on their healing journeys. And I just want to share my experiences and insights that I get from that process. In the hopes that it touches and encourages and inspires you in some positive way. And so, in my work where I accompany people, I get on their healing journeys, I really get to witness not only the healing itself, but all the layers of stories people have about their healing process. There's stories around the guilt and shame of even needing healing, of coming to treatment, the guilt and shame of waiting too long to come to treatment, or the frustration around the process and why it's taking so long, or why aren't I at a different place than I am? Why is it taking so long? And there's all these stories that people have about not only there's the healing they're doing, and then there's these stories they tell themselves about their healing process that I just want to shift. I want to shift the stories that people tell about their healing process, because healing is such a sacred process. And if you are on a healing journey or a healing process, I want you to really honor it and know that you are doing such incredible work, not only for yourself, but for the greater good of the collective. So I want you to really know that your own personal healing is a really the greatest contribution you can make. It's a real act of service and a love, act of love to yourself and to the greater good. Because when we heal ourselves, we can serve life and we can serve the greater good from such a deeper place of wellness and wholeness. It's sort of, I love using water as an example. We all drink from many levels of water sources. There's the surface water, and then there's the deep underground wells that are really connected to the core of the earth itself. And when you continue your healing journey, what you're doing is you're really going deeper and deeper and deeper so that you can access this deep groundwater well inside of you that is your direct connection to the earth and to life itself. And when you can access that, then you can bring all of that to the surface and share it so that it can nourish everyone. So wherever you're at in your healing journey, if you're just beginning or you've been doing it for years, this is encouragement that it's just to keep on going. And it's an infinite process, but to keep on going until you really reach that deep place inside of yourself that is your own direct wellspring connection to life itself. And part of what I'm here to share is that we all have the capability of accessing that. We all do. It's not just some of us, it's all of us. We all have this capability of accessing that deep wellspring inside of us. And so just to keep going on your healing journey, know that it's a sacred process and that you're doing so much work for yourself and the greater good. And another thing I wanted to share about this is that our outer worlds, what we experience in our outer environments, is a reflection of our inner world. So, right now in our outer worlds, we see a lot of chaos, conflict, confusion, anxiety, fear, stress, turmoil, disparity, poverty. There's a lot of unsettling things we see in our outer environments. And that is a reflection of the inner environments of the human collective, that humans are experiencing this inside of themselves, the fear, the anxiety, the separation, the division, the conflict. So the more you can work on your inner self, the more people that can access an inner state of peace and well-being and love and harmony and beauty, then that's how you experience life, and that's how you contribute and create life. So your own work, your own inner work to find that place of peace and joy and well-being and hope and harmony in yourself contributes to the collective outer environment. So the more you can do to access that yourself, and it's possible for everyone, you are doing your contribution to the greater good. So this message was really just to honor everyone's healing journey and to encourage you to keep going, keep doing it, and know that you're doing it not only for yourself, but you're really doing it for the greater good and the collective. So thank you for listening, and I'll catch you next time.